Islander hockey is fast-paced. Islander hockey is exciting. Islander hockey is on Cablevision Sports 3. That's right, you've got a reserved seat for all of the action on the home of the Islanders, Cablevision Sports 3. After a disappointing loss in the playoffs last season, the Islanders are primed and ready to go all the way to the Stanley Cup. This could end up being the year of the Islander.
The Islanders take on the Flames tomorrow at 8 p.m. on Sports 3.
Remember back a few years ago.
Let's pick the action up and watch the swinging stick.
Well, this is because of the incident earlier. Look, there's no need for that. Now, Garry Howatt has to retaliate a little bit, and he does. But now look what happens. Now he goes after him. Here the goalie's going after him. He's going to try and take control of the game. And he thinks, now, even though he's got the mask on, he is actually getting some pretty good shots at him, because what is happening...
Oh, he got his shots in. There's no question.
The mask is form-fitting to your nose, and all you got to do is keep banging the side of it, and you can break the goaltender's nose.
That has to hurt. You feel that through that mask. You've got to feel it.
I'll tell you, there's a little man who just did a super job there, because not only had to take on a goaltender, but then John Winsick. And when you look at it, here's John Winsick with 28 goals out for the game. And Garry Howatt, you got to give him his credit. He took a few bumps there, but I'll tell you, he'll be back. And I feel sorry for Jim Petty.
Mickey at 3-12. Here are the Rangers.
Made the threatening gesture. Now we're going to get a penalty. And it looks like it's going to be Hoyta for running into Mike Kosicki. Now we've got Clark Gillies and Hoyta.
Wow, Gillies really went after Hoyta from behind, and now Gillies is really throwing some right uppercuts to Dave Hoyta. He didn't like the way that Hoyta run at Bossy in the corner, and it seemed like Gillies got more of the right hands in on Dave Hoyta. He hit him with about three or four good uppercuts and a couple of overhand rights. And Hoyta's down on the ice, being held to by the linesman Jim Christensen. Now Hoyta's up, and he still wants to get at Gillies. They'll be getting major penalties. We'll have to see exactly what, if Gillies will get any extra.
Could be third man in, but we'll find out after we come back from this match.
Wilson from behind to pull him off, his teammate, and then Celeste got in to grab a hold of Resch, but Ron Wicks now is really going to have his hand filled. Ben Whistlin wanting to get at Mike Bossy. He was getting the upper hand, and that's when Resch came in to try and grab a hold of him. Now Wilson's still trying to carry on the fight. Now they've let him go.
Here comes Resch again.
And Wilson is really good. Now here comes Trottier and Lewis. Resch is coming in again to help him. Here comes Howard.
Nice off the bench.
Howard. Everybody's off the bench for the Islanders. Now here comes the Flyers, and we're going to have a real Donnybrook. Here's Billy Harris. Ran right into Bob Kelly. Knocked him down to grab a hold of him. Richmond has a hold of somebody. You can't see the number, but Gillies came out of the penalty box, and Dave Hoyta is being held. But now Howard went over and hit Dave Hoyta as he was being held by linesman Christensen. Jerry Watson has a hold of Tonelli. Bridgman and Hart are going at it. Bridgman and Hart had started last Thursday, and Bridgman has really laid some right hands on. Now Billy Smith, and finally Pete Peters comes out of the goal as he was sitting there. But Bridgman and Hart are going at it. They started that in Thursday when Hart slashed Bridgman in the mouth for 9 stitches. Well, the main bout was with Ben Wilson and Mike Bossy.
Well, I've never seen this before.
Now Hart has been turned over.
Ron Wicks has got a score sheet out at center ice trying to keep track of all the penalties. Nystrom get a double minor in a game misconduct first off the bench. Both goaltenders for leaving their crease in an all occasion. We could have third man in. We could have a host of penalties. We will have a host.
Now Bridgman has a real good hold of Hart and is really lowering it. Now Gillies has grabbed a hold of Bridgman. Now Hart and Bridgman are squared away now. We could have a real... Thank you. Hart seems to be cut over the nose and the eye from Bridgman's punches. They've been weighing their chance to get it. Bridgman, of course, upset with Hart when he slashed him in the stick. He went straight to the Islander player. Seems everybody's paired away now. But now Billy Smith and Bob Kelly are going at it down by the penalty bench. Smith had Kelly's sweater over his head. Now Kelly's got Smith's sweater over his head. And they're tussling with each other. Seems everybody seems to be quiet down except Dave Hoyta and Garry Howatt have got a hold of each other. That could erupt into something. Now Smith is getting held on by Bob Kelly.
Well, has Smith just got a red face or is he cut? I think he's just red from being bumped. Now Frank Bathe and Bob Lorimer are grabbing. Seems to have settled down a bit now as everybody's paired off. And we've got one group, one quartet, and one quintet now.
Hoyta's with with Garry Howatt, the two number eights on the team. Howatt had a fight with Gillies earlier, and this just before this started. Gillies getting the better of it.
Hart's gone for the night. He's been escorted to the dressing room. I'm sure Mel Bridgman will be as too. But I figure Hoyta, Gillies, Wilson, Bossy, Resch, Peters.
Now Bossy. Hoyta and Howard are going at it. Hoyta's landing them right hands on Howard, knocking him to the ice. Hoyta didn't already even throw a punch. Eddie Westfall has jumped in there. McLeish has got a hold of Eddie Westfall. Keep him away, but Dave Hoyta really hit some good right hands on Garry Howatt, knocking him to the ice with one right cross. Now Hoyta's on the ice. Garry Howatt took a beating. He wants some more. This is Hoyta's second fight. He's gotten beat at home. Now he wants to pick up a stick and go after Hoyta.
Oh, and Ed Westfall grabbed him as soon as he saw that motion. As soon as he saw that motion, Ed Westfall went over wisely. And now DuPont over there on the far side. Now they're going to get, is Howard's hand cut? Maybe that's why.
Yes, it is. He's really cut.
There's a lot of bad pain there.
He really took a beating by Dave Hoyta.
Just did.
It all started with Hoyta and Gillies. As Hoyta really buried Mike Bossy with a check, Gillies came over. And Clark Gillies really got the best of the fight with Dave Hoyta. He hit him with about three or four really good right hands, and Hoyta was not able to throw a punch. Of course, there's a little bit of a slight height disadvantage, but Clark Gillies, one of the toughest players in the National Hockey League, as well as being one of the biggest. That's what started it.
Guy, all right. At the Spectrum tonight in Philadelphia, the Islanders broke their two-game losing streak, beat the Flyers 4-1 despite only 18 shots on goal. Bossy had number 40. Let's go to the videotape, pick it up right here, 3 minutes into the first period, and we see Mike Kosicki, who fakes the shot against Stevenson, then comes in around him, scores 1-0. Look at this collision between Stevenson and teammate Dunlap. Third period, it's 1-1. Gillies makes it 2-1. 5 minutes later, Bossy 3-1. Henning made it 4-1, and that was it.
Great pressure by the Soviets with a minute and 55 seconds left in the opening period. And they have been, I would think, the better hockey club in this first period, although the score is tied at a goal. Now they fight for possession in Soviet territory. Gillies fires.
A tough line. Three great hockey players.
Bryan gets the goal. Bryan Trottier. From behind the net, trying to get this. Serves power play into effective operation. Old Gillies was hit just outside the line. Now center ready in front. They score! Bossy!
What a play Trottier makes it. He couldn't hold him. Makes a great play to Bossy, and Bossy can put the puck in the net. Tedjak gets a piece of it. 1-1.
All right, we'll take a look here. As it comes riding on the Soviet goal, Tedjak does get a chance. A piece of it, as Bobby mentioned, but it's off the skate through his leg. And the power play pays off. Mike Bossy.
Clark Gillies made a great play right at center ice to get the puck ahead.
Door up
and there's that pesky diminutive line for the Soviets. Finally, the Stars get it out. Sittler clearing it ahead, and down it goes on the right side. Vernikov to Babanov, behind the net into the corner. Fedorov up on the left wing for Vernikov, and it's called on the offside.
So the scoring play again for Team NHL. There's the youngster who got it, Mike Bossy. Trottier and Gillies assisting at 13:35.
Bobby, a tremendous.
A shot of the United Nations seems entirely fitting as we bring you this International Challenge Cup hockey series of the National Hockey League ahead 2-1 over the Soviet Union at the end of the first period in this, the second game. Kapustin put the Soviets in front, and it was all USSR up to that point and after it. But then the power play goal by Mike Bossy got the NHL started, and Bryan Trottier scored to make it 2-1. The Islander line of Bossy, Trottier, and Clark Gillies has now accounted for four of the NHL's six goals in this series. And with me is the captain of the Islanders, one of that trio, Clark Gillies. I think we should probably start by talking about the fact that you're playing together as a unit and really the only forward line that is for the NHL. How much is it helping you?
I think definitely it's a big advantage, Dave, because we've played together for the last year and a half, and you know, we know basically where each one of us is going to be on the ice at any given moment. And, you know, some of the other guys, there are two guys from one team playing on each of the other lines. But, you know, sometimes it's tough to fit the third guy in there. And I think that, you know, with the three of us playing together like that, it makes it much easier.
You hit several Soviets and roused the crowd in game number one. I wonder how effective you thought it was, because we keep hearing that no matter how hard you hit them, it's not going to make any difference.
Well, that's what I was told, that they never show any emotion after you hit them or anything. But I hit some guys pretty good the other night, and had a couple guys yelling at me. But I think, you know, it's part of the game. And if you can, you know, the fact isn't to hurt them, it's to, you know, take them out of the play. And I think it works pretty effectively, because they like to use the give and go. And if you can take that first guy out that passes the puck, then he's got nobody to give it to. So,
are they easier targets than your NHL opponents?
Definitely. They just skate around, they make a pass, and they look where it goes. And as they're looking, that's the best time to hit them. And they don't bring their sticks up or anything, so you just got a free shot at them.
You had to take a solid hit to get the play started for the first NHL goal today. And I wonder if you think they're hitting you harder today than they were on Thursday.
Well, you know, they are playing stronger in the corners, much stronger, and they're forcing us a little bit on that play. I was, you know, more or less just trying to get the puck, and the guy hit me, and luckily it went forward. But you know, they are strong fellas, and they'll hit you if they get a chance. So, you know, you got to keep your head up.
Was there any worry about overconfidence after the first game? It was a somewhat easy victory. You had the game in control, seemingly, from the first minute when you went up 1-0. Did you have any thoughts that you might relax just a little bit coming into this game?
I think there was a chance that we might, but, you know, there's guys on our team that have played against them a number of times in different tournaments, and you know, they know well that the first game they didn't play that well, and they come out tonight, and we knew they were going to play a lot better than they did Saturday, because I'm sure, like us, they were a little nervous, and we just happened to get the jump on them, and, you know, they are playing much, much better than they did Thursday night.
Did Scotty Bowman ask you to make any adjustments in your game for today based on what he saw on Thursday?
Well, we've heard a lot about the referee, Dombrowski, and I just figured, you know, I thought I threw clean checks the other night, and the guys just said, you know, if you're going to hit somebody, just keep your arms down and take them with the shoulder, and, you know, that's basically what I'm going to try and do.
We're going to Canada with this telecast. Do you have any messages you'd like to send?
Yeah, I always get hell for not saying hello to my family, so I say hi to Mom and my brother and my sister and everybody at home.
Consider it done. He wanted to say it, and he did. Clark, congratulations on a great series so far to your line mates as well and the rest of the team. It's been quite a series. Are you enjoying it?
Oh, it's super. It's the biggest part of my career right now. I think the next step will probably be getting into the Stanley Cup Finals, because that's where our team wants to get. And I'm just having a great time. The guys are great, and we've got a real good team spirit going here, and it's super.
We're enjoying watching you. Clark Gillies, who assisted on both NHL goals in the first period, live from New York. This is the Challenge Cup.
On the left point, now it's Potvin. Potvin put it out in front, they score!
Mike Bossy. Just a little turn-in on a perfect pass across. He was out of the slot. And he just put it inside the corner over Vachon's glove. And that ties a National League record with both Bathgate and Hull. The 10th straight game this boy has scored goals. And his 49th of the season. a pass from Pearson across the point. Now a little dump pass by Potvin into Bossy, and he just changed directions. Wilkie Vachon got a part of it with his glove and tipped it down in underneath. It was just a little
minute. Trotze handing it to Bossy, right out in front, he scores. And so he's got his 50th goal. And a 2-0 Islander lead in the whole New York Penn-50s. And they come out to congratulate their second-year man, and now in his first 2 years.
30 years ago tonight, Dennis Potvin hit the Rangers' Ulf Nielsen into the boards, injuring him and bringing him very rapidly to the end of his career. Ranger fans never forgot that hit, and the chant derisive of Dennis Potvin exists to this very night at Madison Square Garden all these years later.
Standards, it has not been a great week of hockey. Two losses and a narrow victory over Toronto. Tuesday night in New York, the Islanders' Clark Gillies had the hat trick in a 7-3 win. Those two teams back.
The Islanders in a blowout of the Boston Bruins. The final was 7-2, a game that began with the announcement that the popular 18-year veteran Eddie Westfall, an original Islander, announced his retirement effective at the end of this season, and Eddie heard it from the crowd. And then the Islanders went out and clobbered Boston, led by Mike Kosicki, who scored two goals within the first 13 minutes of the game. This off the beautiful setup by Harris and Bourne. And for Mike Bossy, his fourth hat trick of the season. He now has 57 goals. Bryan Trottier had four assists on the night. He takes over the NHL scoring lead with 110 points, and the Islanders now within 2 points of Montreal.
Bobby Bourne scored twice. Bossy had his 48th goal. He's now scored in 9 straight games. The National Hockey League record is 10. Let's go to the videotape, pick it up. 1:39 into the game, and we see Dave Lewis break the scoreless tie, and it's 1-1. Second period, Komodowski and Nystrom really go at it. Look at Nystrom's right hand. Lands 5-6-7. Now 2-1 and yet 1. Then John Tinelli and Terry O'Reilly went at it for a while. Third period, Bossy goal number 57 made it 7-1. All right, Mike, and the Islanders and Mario Marwa.
Canadians for the best record in the National Hockey League. They both have 98 points. Islanders picked up 2 points tonight with their 6-2 win over Toronto. Bryan Trottier scored 3 goals and went ahead of Guy Lafleur by 4 points in the NHL scoring race. This was Trottier's second goal of the game, which is 42nd of the year. The hat-trick goal came when everyone tried to hook Bryan, but he wouldn't stand for it. He went in on Palmateer. The rest is history. Islanders won it 6-2.
Meanwhile, at the Nassau Coliseum, the Islanders beat the Leafs. They are now tied with Montreal, 98 points. Both teams have 12 games to go. Let's go to the videotape of last night's game. The Leafs in the blue and the Islanders in the home white. Pick it up in the first period. And Bryan Trottier, with a hat trick, scores his first goal to make it 1-0. After Trottier scored again, Dennis Potvin shoots 3-0. 3 minutes later, Stefan Pearson 4-0. And then Trottier, here comes the hat trick. That made it 5-0, 43 goals for Trottier. Watch Billy Smith here, the goalie, against Lanny McDonald. Smith is only 5'9", 175 pounds. Go, Smitty. Battling Billy Smith, pouring it on with Lanny McDonald, who may have severely bruised the fingers of his...
Those must-win games tonight at the Nassau Coliseum. They were playing Buffalo, and it wasn't so much that they had to beat the Sabres, per se, but another loss would have dropped them further behind the Canadiens. Well, they came through in the clutch as they won it 2-0. Became 1-0 when Wayne Merrick shot and Bob Sauvay made the save, but Nystrom was there, and he knocked home the rebound right there. It was 1-0. That's all Chico Resch needed. He was unbelievable tonight in the nets for the Isles. He was stopping everything that came at him. Bob Bourne eventually did score a late-period goal. That made it 2-0 as the Isles won the game. Elsewhere,
come from behind win for the Islanders, beating the Atlanta Flames 3-2. The Islanders trail Montreal now by only 1 point in the race for the best record in hockey. The Islanders down 2-1 early in the third when Bryan Trottier on a breakaway beat Rajon Lemelin. It was Trottier's 46th goal of the season, tying his career high. Then the winner from Billy Harris, this amazing effort. Harris flat on his back after being tripped on the breakaway, manages to push the puck past Lemelin. The replay, Harris scores with 7:21 left. The Islanders win for only the second time in their last 6 games. They're now 1 point behind.
Harris has been blessed with. He had a sensational rookie season last year, but this year has been unbelievable. Today he scored 4 goals as the Isles beat the Flyers 9-2. Now Mike Bossy has now scored 120 goals in 152 games. That's almost unheard of. This was the first time that he had ever scored 4 in 1 game as a professional, but with the talent he's got, there are are bound to be more four-goal games. He now has 67 goals for this season, which is 9 short of the record set by Phil Esposito when he tallied 76. The first 4 shots Bossy took today he scored on is the 22-year-old.
The NHL quarterfinal playoff round underway tonight. Moments ago, the Rangers beaten in overtime in Philly. Penalties in game number 1, a 6-2 romp over Chicago. Apparently, the week-long layoff did not hurt Mike Bossy and his friends. This number 1 for Mike, 1 of 3 on the night, picking right up on a 69-goal season. Number 2 at 14:25 of the second, giving the Islanders a 4-2 lead. And number 3 right here, late third, making at 6-2, and that the final. John Tinelli had a big night with 3 assists. Game 2 of this series will take place at the Coliseum.
New York City, where both teams in that area are in the quarterfinals, with the action Tuesday night at the Nassau Coliseum. The Islanders hosting the Chicago Blackhawks. And Mike Bossy, the incredible 22-year-old scoring machine, was the big story with a hat trick. Here's the first goal scored by Bossy on Tony Esposito from the slot. Number 2 from the right side rattles in off the goal post. And finally, he completed his hat trick with a good wrist shot low into the net. A New York paper today had a cartoon about Bossy saying to him, "What are you going to do, kid, when you grow up?" And Mike replied, "Open a hat store." The Islanders win.
Islanders making changes. Ribble starts it out to Filipov. Stolen neatly by Bossy. Gets it over to Trottier. Back to Bossy. No goal. Can't control it. Puts it into the corner on the near side, and Trottier is there. Ribble is on him. Ribble and Trottier to the boards, trying to freeze the puck there. Dug out by Gillies. Got the big three together again. Gillies and Kerr scrapping for it. The two of them in the corner. Goes behind the net. Trottier centering pass off front.
Behind the net, and he threw it right out in front. Bossy gets right in front of the net, and he took the puck out, just fired it right by Esposito. Here you'll see it go around behind the net. Starts in the corner there, turns around, goes behind the net. You see Reggie Curtin does a pretty good job on Gillies. He throws it back behind the net. Here comes the Bossy. There he is. Look at that. Right behind Esposito.
Took 2 minutes and 31 seconds.
Bossy is fourth for the playoff.
And the number one line, Bossy, with the hat trick last night. Fourth goal of the series tonight. Assisted by Trottier and Gillies. 2 minutes and 31 seconds. And the Hawks, playing one of their finest games, fall to defeat.
Semifinals. They'll meet the winner of this Philadelphia-New York Rangers series. The Islanders demolish Chicago in 4 straight. In Chicago, Sunday night, they won the game 3-1 at the Chicago Stadium. Dennis Potvin, the only defenseman to score over 100 points in regular season play, opened the scoring for the Islanders from Howard and Nystrom late in the first period. His third goal is 7th playoff point. Veteran Eddie Westfall, a few games away from retirement, made it 2-0 from Merrick and Pearson. Then Mike Walton, a late season acquisition by the Chicago Blackhawks, scored the lone Blackhawk goal to snap a Chicago scoring drought that went back 182 minutes and 50 seconds. Here, Mike Walton from the side beats Billy Smith on a short rebound shot. Then Mike Bossy put the game out of reach for the Islanders with his 5th playoff goal, his 74th goal of the season. And that was it. And this may be the last game in a Chicago uniform for veteran netminder Tony Esposito. And the Chicago crowd realized it. They gave him a standing ovation. Congratulations from the Blackhawks. Islanders win it 3-1.
Trottier shot. Score.
There's Trottier fired. There's the play on the left side. You saw it, Johnson. He was way out of your picture there. And it went by. It is Trottier, his second in the playoff.
Pass to Kachuk. Save.
There's Esposito. He had a loose puck.
They might have had him. There's a penalty coming up. Smith holds. There's a penalty been called. Penalty called as he pulled him down. Shot is stopped on a save. Overcame it.
have come out with the tie in the first.
Esposito. Centered, and Hedberg was too closely checked by Kosicki. Islanders come back. Potvin flipping it in. Potvin has it again. A drive. He scores! Dennis Potvin!
Well, Dennis Potvin taking a drop pass and probably using Tonelli as a screen, fired that puck, and it seemed to go right through Davidson's legs right after the Rangers had missed on a great chance when Esposito tried to set up Hedberg.
Shot Maloney wide. Back to center zone. Look out. One on one. Open net. Score.